Hey everyone, it's Blake. Welcome in to part two of the How I Book series. We did one video already of this, and you guys seemed to enjoy it, and there were a lot of questions coming out of it. So I thought I answered most of them in the comments, but there were some that I thought it would kind of be fun to expand on a little bit more and kind of do it in video form, and so you could visually kind of see what I'm talking about whenever, again, I answered some of those questions. So I know some of you, you know, we'd already kind of planned to do a part two of this. So that's what we're going to do here. And we'll just kind of jump around. This won't necessarily be as structured as the first video. We're just kind of going to jump around between different things to answer some of your questions and also kind of jump into some of the things I didn't mention on the last video. So let's jump in. Before I jump into the questions, there's one thing I did forget to add into the first video. And this is something that normally, to be honest with you, I don't do in a spreadsheet, but I was like, all right, how can I visually do this so everyone can sort of see how I do it? One thing I also found helpful in terms of coming up with storylines, which is kind of more the focus of the first video, this one will kind of be more in-game stuff and that kind of thing. But one thing I found just really helpful, like if I get stuck, which again, I said I get stuck a lot, but The way I do it, and if you've used like a mind map before, you can Google it, whatever. Like if you haven't used one, if you don't know exactly what it is, it's a very simple thing, which basically what the way I do it is just basically just take out a sheet of paper. And what I do is I'll put a name. So like let's say I'm stuck and I want to come up with a big storyline. Well, let's just use Roman Reigns, for example. You know, he's the center of what I want to do. He's the center. He's someone I need to do something for. Like there's something that we need to do with Roman Reigns. I don't exactly know what that's going to be, who we want to kind of pair him with and those kind of things for storylines. So what I can do is, again, I don't use a spreadsheet for this, but this is something you can do in a spreadsheet. It's just simple. I put Roman Reigns on a piece of paper. I put the name in like the center of the paper and basically just draw a circle around it. And what you do from there is you kind of build it out like with all these connections. So I'll draw a line to the left, I'll draw a line to the right, I'll draw a line up, down, and then you just put another wrestler in there. So what is the, who does Roman Reigns have some sort of connection with, right? So if I'm trying to just come up with anything, any ideas where I'm like, I'm just so stuck, I don't know what to do. Okay, well, here's what we know. We know that Reigns has, you know, obvious connections with Jon Moxley, Seth Rollins, Brock Lesnar, and then you can keep going. Triple H, you know, and you just keep going on down the line. John Cena, AJ Styles. You know, you can come up with just kind of past things that there's pairings with there. I mean, I guess technically, Shield versus Wyatt family. You could do Bray Wyatt. And, you know, you can see how quickly I've moved through this. Like, you know, and I know this sounds very simple, but it is something like if I'm just completely like spent and I have no idea what I want to do with Roman Reigns, the easiest thing for me to do is just write down the name Roman Reigns on a piece of paper, put a circle around it, and then just draw lines on each side of that circle and just put these names there. And that just kind of gives you, again, it's like a mind map of these are all the connections. And then from there, I can connect all these dots. Like I'm like, okay, all right, great. Like, you know, Moxley's in AEW, but, you know, then if you want to get a little more, and again, this is something that I just add to the spreadsheet, and I also do this on the paper, but it's not something you have to do. I mean, if you just kind of keep it in your head, you know what the connection with Roman Reigns and Jon Moxley is. Obviously, former Shield member, you know, but Moxley now in AEW. So it's like, okay, well, we know that's not necessarily an option, but if he's in AEW, you know, if he becomes available via contracts in TEW, obviously there's a connection there. Boom, there's a storyline we could run with. Rollins, you know, basically the same thing. Former Shield member, you know, complicated relationship, I guess the best way to put it with those two at times. You know, Brock Lesnar, you know, obviously there's the Paul Heyman connection. Main evented WrestleMania 873 times. I'm just kidding. You know, and it's stuff like that. Like, that's just, that's the way for me. Like, if you're really, again, struggling, which was kind of one of the, some of the comments that were made, I think, like in the previous videos, and you guys have said it before on other videos, it's just, that helps me really come up with something. So like, it really is just easy. You can do it in this form. You can do it on a piece of paper, which I think is honestly just as easy. Just take out a piece of paper, pen, write a name in the middle of the paper, and then just connect all these guys. And then if you want to do a little, you know, you can write underneath it to the side, here's the connection. And then that usually, you know, that'll get my brain going in terms of, okay, well now, you know, let's say, I don't know, let's say for John Cena, right? You know, we know the whatever storyline there, Vince's chosen ones, Cena, let's say Cena in current storyline with whoever. Let's go back to our guy, Sami Zayn. So we know at that point, like, we can't necessarily use Roman versus Cena because, you know, he is in a current storyline with Sami Zayn in our game. And but we know there's history there. Like, these are the kind of things that I think are just so, you know, it's connecting all those things. And I like to use, which if you've watched our WWE save specifically, I like to use, you know, that history and really build in the history there. And honestly, that's one of the reasons why that save has probably gone as long as it has, is because with WWE specific, and I know, again, not everyone plays WWE and that's fine, but there's so much like the, I guess it's, you know, not exactly the world building, but like the background aspect, the history aspect of things, that's what can kind of keep me going. I'm like, all right, I can go back to this. I can go back to that because it is something that there's history there. And again, you know, that's obviously don't want to do the same thing over and over and over again, but it's kind of easier for me to come up with ideas. And look, it could be something too where it's like, okay, I've done this as well. I've done it the opposite way, which I don't want to complicate it, but where it's like, okay, let's say Roman Reigns is the person I want to do something with. These are the guys that I know there's deep history there. Like, we can build off of some previous history with these wrestlers. But I could also do it the complete opposite way, where I say, who does Roman Reigns not have any history with, right? Who's a completely fresh feud? Who's something new that I want to throw him in there with? Who does he have, you know, nothing with, okay? I don't know. Like, I guess I'm trying something. Like, I'm trying to think of who he has no. And obviously, I could just look up and down my roster, right? I could look in the roster and say, okay, yeah, there you go. Like, he has nothing going on with Ricochet. Which you followers of the WWE save will know that my enjoyment of putting Ricochet in there, given what we've dealt with him in our series. But Roman Reigns and Ricochet, there you go. Like, there's something where there's really no history whatsoever. And now I can kind of do it the opposite, where like, okay, all the history here. So I'm looking at Roman Reigns. Would I rather go to something like this? You know, do I want to go something with completely new? And if I do, I can just build, you know, my own storyline out from there and decide, okay, here's what I want to do with Reigns and Ricochet, because there's no history before, but, you know, how do I build that in now? And is there a way to connect, you know, no history here to something up here with one of these guys? Like, those are just the things that, again, it's not a perfect system. It just, it gets my mind going. And to me, that's the most important thing. It's just, it gets ideas going somehow, some way. They don't have to be perfect. They don't have to be clean necessarily. Like, it doesn't have to be a pretty process. It's just, this is what gets my mind going to where I'm like, oh, okay, well, there we go. Like, you know, Bray Wyatt has nothing going on in my save. He just completed his whatever storyline with Triple H. Great. Well, now let's put Roman and Bray together. Let's build on some history and let's go from there. Like, it's, you know, it's just those kind of things. So that was something I did want to mention because I did kind of forget to put that in the previous video, but it is something that's helped. Like I said, mostly do it on paper, but look, you can add this to the spreadsheet just like this if you want, if it's easier for you to see it or however you want to do it. So I did want to kind of point that out on that. All right, let's jump into some of these questions, and I'll try not to be too long-winded on these. Let's start here. One of the questions was, do you stick to your long-term stories pretty closely, or do you adjust quite a bit based on new signings and injuries? I would really appreciate if you could do a sample booking and what steps you take in the game to book a show. Just wanted to get an idea on how to get these 80 rating segments, which I rarely get, even with Roman Reigns or KO, you know, not like 90s and those kind of things. What am I doing wrong? Well, look, I don't by any means claim to be a perfectionist when it comes to getting the ratings, especially because I don't always do a great job with that. But I'll answer the first part first. And sticking to like long-term stories closely. So if we go to like our story template, which is the one, again, if you haven't watched part one, I would highly suggest doing that first because you may, that's where like all the stuff we went through, all the tabs and everything that I use on that. But, you know, do I adjust a bit based on like signings and injuries? Absolutely. So, you know, that is something, this was kind of just an idea we put together on the last thing. We ran through it pretty quickly, but yes, like I do adjust stories based on signings, injuries, those kind of things. To me, and I think I said this previously, all this is like a baseline. This just gives me something to start with, and it gets me from destination, you know, this destination to this destination or whatever that is at the end point down here. And again, that's usually the easiest. Like for me, and I know I've seen some other people do this, and this is the best way to do it, and I mentioned it last time. Like, it's just, it's planning, what are the big matches I want to get to? Like, if I'm booking, let's say I'm starting at some, I don't know, let's say I'm starting at Survivor Series, okay? And I know I want to get to WrestleMania. This is impromptu on this sheet. You can do it any way you want. But, like, if I know I want to get to Roman Reigns versus, and I know we're in this Kevin Owens storyline sheet, but just work with me here. If I know I want to get to, I don't know, Roman Reigns versus Kevin Owens at Survivor Series, and I know that, you know, at WrestleMania, I want it to be Reigns versus, I don't know, let's go with whoever, Reigns versus Cena, and I know I want to do Owens versus, I'll just do Rollins, whatever. So that's kind of what I want to get to, right? Now, if these are my starting points. So, like, this is where I want to get to. But, you know, if there's injuries come along, I have to pivot, which if you're watching our WWE Save right now as I'm doing this, you know, we just had a big injury take place right before the Rumble for a championship match that we had scheduled. And, you know, it's like quickly I have to pivot now with two shows left to figure out how I'm going to do that. So obviously you guys know, like, injuries certainly play a role in terms of, like, then that's not just going to adjust what we did at the Rumble, right? Like, that's going to adjust what we're doing and everything I kind of had booked out right after the Rumble, because that injury is going to affect that. So I just have to go back from the start and say, okay, well, we need to fix this here. We need to fix this spot here. And then how does that connect with everything else going on? So that's kind of something. New signings, yes. Like, I sometimes get the, you know, shiny object syndrome, but where I see, you know, there's a signing out there, oh man, I've got to sign them. But then it's like, I usually try to be more, okay, I have to sign them is my first thought. But I'm like, okay, but hold on. What am I going to do with that person? Am I just going to sign them to sign them, or am I actually going to have a plan for this person? And I'm not always perfect with that, but that is something that I certainly think about. And yes, like, if there's new signings, and, you know, again, to go back to this, if there's new signings where I'm like, okay, this person's out there, and again, let's use John Moxley as the example, right? If John Moxley becomes available, and then obviously I'm going to sign him, and that's probably going to throw off something that I had in mind for either Roman Reigns or Seth Rollins, because there is a history there. I can build that connection between Moxley, Rollins, and Reigns. And so, yeah, that's going to absolutely adjust something. I'm not just going to let John Moxley sit there for 6 months and not do anything. So those are things, you know, that will, I'd rather completely go back and rewrite something than just stay the course without any, you know, just feel like I'm completely locked into everything. I think it's great to do that. Like, I'll go back through and, sure, if I have to rewrite something that I've already built out 6 months in advance, that's okay, because that's just kind of a new challenge for me in terms of playing like a game, which is, you know, obviously what we're doing. Like, it's just playing a game and coming up with new ideas and kind of playing the game as it lies, I guess you could say. Like, again, if Moxley's available, let's find a way to tie him in with Reigns and Rollins somehow, even if I've already built out a, you know, a 6 month storyline in my head of big matches for Reigns at this pay-per-view and that pay-per-view. So yeah, that is something there. All right. Let's see. I'm going to get to your second part here in a minute. We're going to go to the actual game. I'm going to make sure there's nothing else in the questions. There was another question about, does your booking change if you realize the crowd isn't into a story, or do you scrap stories if you find out the workers have bad chemistry? Bad chemistry, yes, usually does change plans. Although, again, we'll go on our WWE save in a second. But that usually changes my plans unless I'm just kind of far into a feud and a blow-off match is, like, in the works. We had this with, I'll give this away, like, this wasn't a big feud, but, like, we did this in our WWE save where we had Damian Priest and Baron Corbin. We realized the very first match they had bad chemistry. But, you know, the blow-off was only, like, a month away in terms of, like, the final match of the series. So I just went ahead and had that final match, even though I knew it was going to get wasn't going to get a great rating. But, yeah, I think that's something that bad chemistry, I will usually change it, especially if it's like a multiple match series. Let's just go ahead and pivot. But also the luxury you have too, and this is what I'll keep in mind, and I'll point this out in a second. It's who you're playing with. It's like the company. Like, can you afford that bad chemistry? In WWE, I can afford a bad chemistry note with Damian Priest and Baron Corbin because it's not the main event. You know, it's not the match that everything's built on. So I could have a couple matches that have bad chemistry, and I'm perfectly okay with that. Like, it's not going to affect our overall number that much, because they're not the main event program. They're not on top and those kind of things. So, yeah, that is something. I'm going to answer this storyline question here in a second, then we're going to go back to these. All right, let's jump into the game, and, we'll look at some of these other questions and kind of break that down in the game. Okay, so let's circle back around to some of these questions that actually involve the in-game part here, and hopefully I don't give away any spoilers, because I am using my using a copy of my WWE say where we're at right now on the road to the Royal Rumble. But all right, let's look at one of the initial questions about the angles. And I think this will be kind of interesting to look at. So one of the initial questions I said would, looking at the in-game steps to book a show, idea of how to get ratings that are higher, those kind of things. So the way I do it, because you know, I am doing a YouTube video. You know, if I'm looking at the saves that I don't do, you know, videos for, I don't really use freestyle angles a ton. I'll just go through, pick one of these angles and roll with it. You know, so if I'm doing a promo and I'm doing it that isn't really, you know, something that I'm doing for a video, then I'll just go in, pick a person here, you know, rate them, or I'll just use this because they're rated on entertainment. Okay, their entertainment ratings are good enough. Let's pick them, plug her in, boom, we're gone on this one. So, but most of the stuff I do is using freestyle angles because that is where I'm coming up with my own angles, and I can kind of, you know, I'm verbally saying that in the videos that I'm doing. So I pretty much always use freestyle angles, which again, it's a preference thing. Like, I just, because I'm coming up with my own storylines, my own angles for everything in our show, I do it that way. I just find it easier for me to do. And so that's what I do. I'll plug these people in here. And what I try to do is hit on, you know, the top skills for each superstar, which is something that not always I will do. You know, if it's a promo or something, right? If it's Roman Reigns and, you know, I've got him plugged in here, somewhere in there that we can, you know, kind of plug in and do things like that. All right. So there's Roman Reigns, or let's take Robert Roode. Okay. Let's plug in Bobby Roode here and we'll go with him, for now. But all right, we're going to plug in Robert Roode. All right, so we're doing a storyline here for him. So I'll just plug him in here, and, you know, if I go to the roster, chances are I'm going to look at it, and I'm going to see Bobby Roode's highest skills are, you know, going to be, I'm sure, like, he's pretty good on the microphone. You know, his charisma's pretty good and that kind of stuff. So because I have pretty good faith in Bobby Roode and his skills, when we look at it, you know, that's what we would do. We would just do it there, microphone, and then, you know, plug in however many minutes we wanted to do it. I know it's kind of a simple answer, but I just think, again, because I'm doing like a series on YouTube and I'm doing these videos to build up my own angles, it just makes freestyle angles a better choice for me. But you can accomplish like a lot of the same stuff just with normal angles. Like, again, you could accomplish the same thing here if you did it that way. This is just something that I do. And that's just kind of, you know, again, I know it's not like a... It's like a groundbreaking answer, but that's just kind of doing that. And it's really just diving into like the superstar rating. So for example, like if we do that here, like I'm just going to filter my roster here by like the top stars, right? So like if I'm building freestyle angles around some of these people, for example, you know, Big E, obviously Big E, great charisma, good on the microphone, you know, acting, if we need to use that, we can do it. Star quality, menace, like Big E's got a lot of things we can use for all these different notes, right? You know, we could use Big E for a lot of this different stuff, and be able to pull it off. And that's just what I do. Like it's learning, you know, all the top skills. And eventually after a while, you kind of, you know, you certainly remember, okay, well, I know, and it should be just, you know, again, and this is different. Like if you're playing with, you know, the Cornelverse, like it's much different than if you're using WWE, I think, because, you know, you pretty much know the skills of the, you know, that Bray Wyatt's going to be rated highly on this. But if there's like characters you have not played with before, you don't know who, like, it's just, it'll take some getting used to. I have to do that all the time when I'm playing just some random, you know, C-verse saves and stuff. Like, it's just kind of, that's how I do it. So, but, you know, it's just, that's what I try to do. Like, to get the best ratings is, for starters, some of the stuff, like Roman Reigns, if you have, like, your higher ones, and someone pointed this out in the AEW save, and I've always kind of done this, but it's, for me, it's like trying to find the minutes in the shows to put in. But, like, the longer, like, you'll get the note on, like, a segment's too short. So, like, if I do a Roman Reigns segment, for example here, let me pick Roman. I don't know why it's not going to Roman when I click on it here. Never mind. I know why it's not going to Roman now, because I have this as a Raw branded show. Yes, that's why it's not happening. So, let's pick someone else. How about we pick Steve Austin? Let's get to Steve here. I'm just going to go through this. Sorry, I know this is kind of tedious, but a Steve Austin segment. All right. Austin announces main events. That's what we're going to name this. Length matters, like, too, in terms of, you know, a 3-minute Steve Austin segment is not going to do as well as a 7-minute Steve Austin segment when it comes to, like, a promo and those kind of things. It's just, it's going to do better as a longer segment. At least that's what I've, you know, figured out over the years. And maybe someone can prove me wrong if that's not the case. But I just, that's what I've noticed. And again, that's been pointed out, too, like in our AEW save. You know, someone pointed out, obviously, the longer we get those Punk segments, the better the ratings are going to do, and they can pretty much hit a 100. So I would say that it's probably something, if you're looking for just the ratings aspect of it, if you can find enough time to build in like 7-minute or so segments, I would say is a good range. You can, with your top stars, that is, like, so for this group right here, if I could find a way to give them longer promo time, longer segments involving these guys, that usually helps from what I've seen. And again, look, you guys, I just want to make sure this is clear. Like, I'm not a TEW expert by any means. Like, I'm just someone who decided to build a channel and play a bunch of different saves and that kind of thing. But I'm just telling you what's worked for me. And there are way many people out there, I'm sure, that know the ins and outs of the actual game more than I do. But like, this is just me experimenting, and I'm just telling you what's worked for me. So like, these are things that have worked for me. Put the biggest stars in longer segments, which, you know, sounds pretty basic, I know, but like that works. So that is something that has certainly helped, I think, me when I'm doing it that way. So that's what I would definitely make that a big focus. If you're wanting to get better ratings, like I think it was mentioned in the question, like Roman Reigns, Kevin Owens, doesn't hit like the 90s. If you can find a way to make them longer. Now, of course, you have to make them longer as an active participant in the actual angle. If you're doing freestyle, and I'll keep that in mind, if you're doing freestyle, if you're doing some of these other ones, that's a little bit different. But remember, the note that I know a lot of people, you know, have seen bring up before, and I was one where initially I was like, man, what am I doing wrong? But like, it can't just be a Steve Austin segment that's rated on, you know, you'll get the lack of anything going on note, right? Which I'm sure everyone has seen at one point or another. So it can't just be Steve Austin, overness or whatever, I think, or those kind of things. Like it can't be that for 7 or 8 minutes. It's got to be something that's active. So microphone, promos, you know, fighting. I think sometimes if you do fighting too long, which is kind of, you know, let's say you're building like a brawl with Austin and someone else. If you do that for too long, that's going to give you the note of, I don't remember what the exact note is, but I'm sure someone can tell me. I got it with one of the AEW say something we had like a brawl between two teams or something, and I had it longer than it needed to be, and it was like, oh, these guys can't be fighting for this long. So you may get those kind of notes. So it needs to be something active. And again, that's playing to the best skills. Like for an Austin promo, 7 minutes or whatever, that's gonna do 90 plus. I can pretty much guarantee it. Just because his ratings are very good, his popularity ties into that. It's very good. But yeah, as long as it's the lack of anything going on, and that's something that, you know, you can find too. Like on a, I'm pretty sure, like if you go to the like right here, you can see like the uninteresting angles part, all that. It gives you, yeah, I was trying to find the right word. Passive. Passive is what I was trying to figure out. It can't be angles if you're doing freestyle, where it's passive stuff. So stuff outside of, you know, the microphone, the promos, the fighting, those kind of things. So like charisma, sex appeal, those kind of things. Like you can't make those that long. Those need to be a little bit shorter segments. So if I'm using, for example, like an Asuka video package, which I did in a recent save or a recent video, that would be probably more like, okay, man, let's make that like 3 minutes. Because we're going to rate that on Asuka's, I don't know, menace or something, or star quality, something like that. That's kind of what we'd make that a little bit shorter. So nailing the timings can be a little, because you'll get the notes too. Like I've gotten the notes many times on this angle was, you know, too short. Like it could have been longer. Like if you have your top stars, so like you want to, that's a long way, I know, to say that putting your top stars in more minutes in terms of these angles, that usually helps as long as it's picking the right one. But that again, this is just for freestyle angles here, because this is what I use more than anything. But again, you could do promo generic and you could have a lot of the same stuff here with that. So that is something that I do. And yeah, I just think that's kind of been pretty helpful for me. So one of the other questions I had, how do you set up your matches, time limit, road agent notes that you feel are the most noteworthy or useful road agent notes to get a good match rating? All right. So AJ Styles versus Kevin Owens. The reason I didn't show the previous part is I realized on the roster that I had a spoiler. So if you're watching the WWE save, I don't want to give away someone in there that I had signed. All right, so time limits, stamina, all this kind of stuff. Let me point out what I did here. So the notes that I use, I'll kind of look into this, and we'll look at the time part here in a second. So, I mean, honestly, like, the time limit part of it is just, like, you know, stamina ratings, obviously important. By the WWE product, so, like, for example, I'm using this, right? In WWE, like, for the WWE, we know that matches less than 15 minutes will not be able to achieve world-class score. So I have to keep that in mind when I'm doing matches with WWE. And of course, that's based on the product. So that is something that I keep in mind, you know, but still main events between top stars, I don't make every main event 15 minutes, but I do know that that's kind of something that to achieve world-class scores, I need to make it at least 15 minutes, right? So that's something that I'll think about and say, all right, these two stamina-wise, they're good enough. I can do that. Great. There we go. I don't go wild, and you know, again, if you've watched the WWE save, I have not had like a lot of matches that are 20 plus minutes. There's just not a lot that I've done it, because stamina is something that, like, those stamina ratings, like, need to be high from what I've seen. And high is not like a 70. Like, that's, it needs to be quite a bit higher, like for guys to be able to go, you know, without getting some of those stamina notes. So that's obviously important. And again, having the WWE product the way that it is, that I know that, like, aiming for that 15 minutes will help towards the world-class score possibility, even though, again, I don't always do that. Road agent notes. So let's see. I'm trying to look at the different things here. So, I mean, there's obviously, I'll tell you, like, I try to keep it pretty simple. Like, I try to keep most matches, like, as a regular aim. But remember, I'm going to keep saying this in the context of if I'm using WWE, because the overness is enough, like, the popularity is enough, where, like, I don't have to have two guys that are over, you know, huge stars to go out and have to steal the show. Even if, you know, sure, I could aim for it, and it would work fine, but, like, their popularity is probably going to carry the match, and their skills, if they're good enough, it's still going to be a very highly rated match, even if it's just a regular, which, again, I'm just telling you what I've seen playing as many shows as I have. But, you know, if I want to take that shot, I think for me, like, sometimes I overuse still the show, and that's where, as we know here, like, it can, the inconsistency, if you get the inconsistent note, or if you get, like, some of the stamina stuff, that can be an issue that's happened before with me, like, putting guys in the still the show that just don't have the stamina for going some of the matches or the length of the match that I want to do, those kind of things. So that is something that I try to keep this just, again, I use this a bit. I don't want to act like I don't, but I think I overuse it sometimes. I'll just tell you that. Like, I think I use it too much when I think regular match aims can sometimes do the work for me by itself just because I'm using WWE, for example, and the popularity is enough to kind of carry the match, which, again, that goes back to the product too, knowing that it's about your product, right? So, like, if we look at our WWE product here, we know kind of this is the ratio of in-ring action and popularity depending on what gets the best rating. So, like, those are things that I have to keep in mind too. So that is, you know, again, that's something else that I just kind of try to keep in mind, that I don't necessarily have to use still the show a ton. But, like, for example, if I'm using AEW, you know, AEW, I have to have three different match aims, and sure, I could use the same one over and over. But I try to keep that, you know, a little bit different, where maybe I will do a wild brawl. I'll tell you, like, TEW does a great job. Like, this gives me the baseline of what I have to work with here. Like, I know what I need to do. Like, for a wild brawl, I can't get that thing 15 minutes or higher because they're probably going to be in trouble in terms of what I can do with that. So I think that's something that, again, I use more in the AEW save, just because I want to try to... It's just more of a, okay, let me find a challenge. Let me figure out a way to put a brawl on this show and those kind of things, just to do the three different match aims. But honestly, like, everything else, like decisive wins, I do use that a bit, you know, meaning that, you know, there's really kind of looking at if I'm trying to get someone over, right, and I put them against someone else, I'm not always going to use that. If I'm doing, like, a lower mid card or against a main eventer or something, I'm probably not going to do decisive win, because the main eventer is probably not going to be very happy with that. But I do try to do, you know, kind of decisive wins, you know, to make sort of clean finishes, as it says here, and, you know, no restrictions kind of on the popularity changes. So that could be all over the place. It just depends. So that is something I use to kind of increase popularity for guys I'm really trying to push up the card. You know, rarely use, like, spectacle, epic. I think I've used epic maybe one time. But that was, you know, that was probably the biggest match we've done in the WWE save. I won't say what that is, 'cause that'll spoil it if you haven't watched it. But, you know, I'll do that kind of stuff just as a test, but I rarely, you know, use that a whole lot. I'm not using an epic every pay-per-view or anything. But sure, if you have the guys with the skills, could probably, you know, maybe do that. If I do, like, individual focus, if there's someone taking a loss, we've talked about this before, you know, yes, like, I will try to keep them strong. If, you know, if AJ Styles, a main eventer, is losing to a mid-carder via shenanigans or something, and, you know, if AJ doesn't want to do the job, great, we'll click, you know, keep strong. That'll usually help. Maybe that pushes him to want to be, okay, I'll do the job with that. And, you know, also, like I said, I've seen people say different things. I'm like, you know, keep strong, and I'm sure, you know, you guys can comment your own experience in the thing, but, like, I think it's something where, like, if I'm trying to, I've used it both ways. So it's like, especially if I want to push this guy and I need him to lose this match, but I don't want him to lose kind of any popularity or that kind of stuff, okay, I'll use that too. But it is something I think mainly you kind of try to use to limit the popularity bumps from a, you know, a guy losing popularity, or just basically talking him into losing the match. Like, that's, you know, that's kind of where you try to do on that. Like, for example, I'll probably have to spam the keep strong note in my WCW 1998 save, because Hogan won't want to lose to anyone, and he hasn't so far. So that's kind of those things where you have to sort of look at it and figure out that. I do, you know, call and ring, that's another thing. Like I mentioned, like, regular still the show. Like, again, if they have great psychology ratings, yes, like, I will use that. But this is also something that I found using it rarely for me, just with the games I played, the companies I played with, seems to work better by not using it a ton, unless it is the highest of the high. and using them as sort of call in the ring. So that, yeah, that's something else too, where I can't just throw anyone into a call in ring, because it just, they have to have those high. I mean, I'm talking the people I use it with, like they are 80 something plus. Like it's, that's usually kind of where I put it at. So it's not a science. I'm not telling you that's exactly what the aim is, but that's just what I've seen that works, on that. So, you know, slow build, honestly, again, that's something else that if I'm doing longer matches, which I haven't done, a ton of those 30-minute matches, but I did do, we did do like a 30-minute match in one of our WWE ones. We did obviously use slow build because we had two skilled workers and we knew they could pull it off. It's just being able to pace it like that, that is something we try to do, and it worked pretty well. So these are just the ones, again, that you have to kind of just play around with, and you'll see the way they work. And those kind of things. Really, the other road agents notes, I can't say there's a ton of other stuff, unless you're just booking specific finishes here, those kind of things. But I try to keep it simple, more than anything. But again, it's much different if you're trying to just build a company as fast as you can and trying to get the absolute best ratings possible. Then you can take more chances with using some of the stuff like Steal the Show. But again, I really focus on, I try to keep it simple, using what the game gives me, but also trying to build people up using decisive wins, keeping strong, kind of to limit any popularity knocks and those kind of things. So like those are the main things, really. I mean, you could, I use protect a little bit just if you're trying to get a person with weaker in-ring skills, we can do that just to kind of try to hide some of those flaws. But I don't, again, that's something else I don't use a ton. But honestly, I really try to keep it simple, to be honest with you. And those are kind of the things that I've always kind of done. And it just seems to work in terms of how I play the game. So other things just to note, like road agents, I've seen this was one of the questions that was asked. Like what makes like a good road agent if you're going out trying to like hire people to your company to build a good road agent? Like I think it's always sort of been like psychology and respect, I think are like the top two. I know experience is something else I think that helps. So like, and you can split your road agents to where it'll give you the list of guys. But if you're trying to, get those bonuses too from road agents, which I think pretty much everyone we have on the WWE roster here usually gives us a bonus for being a good road agent or whatever. Those are things I would look for. All right. Well, that's kind of just, like I said, sort of a general overview of where things are at, and again, how I use it. Like I said, this is not a science by any means. This is just how I play the game, and I know, again, there will be people that use angles differently, that will use road agent notes differently, and I'm sure like the comment section is a great place. Like I'm telling you, like we have so many great commenters on our videos, I think, and it's just there's a lot of knowledge being spread there. So definitely check out like what other people think, what works for them, because I always say like there's no way everyone plays the game the same, and it's just what's worked for me. That's what's worked for me is the different things, plugging people in, just the skills. Like it really is just studying the roster. And when you have a huge roster like WWE, you're not going to remember everything. I surely don't remember everything when I go into book a show every time and I have to look and say, okay, I forgot this guy. Rating was not as high as maybe I thought it would be like on the microphone. So let's try to keep him away from that. And just those kind of things. And you can obviously plug people in different areas if you're using freestyle, or you can just go in and say, all right, I want Reigns and Styles to have a fight. Let's just plug them in here and boom, off and running. Like we don't even have to think twice about it, but freestyle angles is more of what I use because I'm trying to build my own storylines in my head and just, rating it on that. But I mean, there's so many, like I said, I said before, like just using this can just be so simple just to say, all right, boom, look at all this options I have at my disposal and I can find something here, that works. And I'm going to plug the guys in here that have good ratings and can be rated well on this kind of stuff. So it's like, those are the kind of things that I think that definitely keep in mind when you're doing that. So there you go. There's some thoughts on those questions. I appreciate the great feedback on the previous video. Like I said, this one was a little bit more all over the place, but I wanted to answer some of your questions in terms of, how I'm booking these angles, maybe how you can get some higher ratings. Again, I'm not an expert by any means on this stuff. I'm just a guy who loves playing this game and enjoys wrestling. But yeah, those are just some ideas perhaps to work with. And I'm sure there'll be more questions coming out of this. And again, more comments. Like, you guys, there's a lot of great knowledge. So feel free to add, you know, what's worked for you in the comments, because I think that would be very helpful to people. Those kind of things. If there are any road agent notes you find that have really helped you the most, like I said, those were the ones for me that I've noticed playing as many, you know, booking as many shows, many matches, angles. I've just found out those are the ones that work for me, but that's not going to be the case for everybody, because everybody's playing a different save. And so those kind of things, like if you have that, leave them in the comments, let people know what you've seen that works, whether it's road agents, you know, time limits, building popularity, those kind of things. Yeah, let everybody know in the comments. And yeah, any more questions you have, drop them down there as well in the comments. And yeah, we will maybe add another video to the series. This was just kind of the natural follow-up with a lot of questions, and just kind of looking at some other things that I hadn't mentioned previously. So I appreciate you guys as always. Thanks for the great feedback. Be sure to like, share, subscribe. And yeah, any other questions you have, any comments, knowledge, leave them in the comments below. And again, appreciate your feedback as always.